Is it possible for a helmet to read the human mind? In light of the advances recorded by modern science, nothing is impossible. If the mind can conceive it, then it can become a reality. At least that is what science and technology are all about. Today there is a new technology shining on the horizon, one that can reveal the content of the human mind. In this video, we will let you know more about this helmet and the brain behind its creation. A US company called Kernel is already in the process of releasing a $50,000 helmet that its manufacturer claims can read the minds of dozens of customers. Weighing just a few pounds, the helmet has sensors and digital spare parts that measure and analyze the electrical impulses of the human brain as well as the flow. The data will provide a clear understanding of how the person responds to the world he or she interacts with. For those who may not know, this technology has been in existence for many years, so it is not new. However, what makes Kernel's helmet markedly different is that it is very small compared to other helmets and technologies that requires patients to sit in confined spaces and which can be highly expensive. Due to the high costs, many businesses were not able to access the old technology, so developers have always been in the process of seeking out a smaller and affordable version. If Kernel is able to mass produce and distribute them as promised, researchers will be able to study the human brain a lot better so as to understand human behavior. Metaphysical experiences like concussions, aging, psychedelic excursions, meditation and stroke will be better analyzed. The project was quite capital intensive. Brian Johnson, the lead inventor, raised about $110 million, half of which was from his purse to fund the development of the helmet. Johnson spent about 5 years developing it, and after a series of trials and errors, the prototype is ready for mass production. Brian Johnson is not new to the technology space, though. He was the founder of Braintree, an electronic payment system. He also bought Venmo before selling both companies for $800 million to eBay. Part of the proceeds for that sale was what he used to fund the helmet project. The dream of the developers is that Kernel helmets will be affordable by 2030, so regular people who earn a regular wage can own one. The first batch of helmets will be delivered to research and medical institutions like Harvard Medical School, a startup company called Cybin Inc. that develops mental psychedelic treatments, and the University of Texas. Professionals in the science and technology community are already calling the Kernel helmet revolutionary, and if the helmets perform as well as Mr. Johnson claims, we expect the results to be outstanding. Two helmets have been created by Kernel developers called Flux and Flow, but how do they work? To function, both helmets use several sensors and lasers to document the electromagnetic activity of the brain and also the blood oxygenation levels. Developers wanted to shrink the size of the brain scanning devices used in hospitals to make them wearable, and this focus formed the foundation for the eventual helmet design. Researchers are now reporting that Kernel helmets can be used to measure brain activity as wearers move around and perform tasks. With this helmet, they will also be able to study the process of brain aging and Alzheimer's disease. But beyond these discoveries, Brian Johnson is thinking bigger. In a statement he released, he said, and we quote, "To make progress on all the fronts that we need to as a society, we have to bring the brain online," Johnson says. "We are the first generation in the history of Homo sapiens who could look out over our lifetimes and imagine evolving into an entirely novel form of conscious existence," he adds. "The things I am doing can create a bridge for humans to use where our technology will become part of ourself." The ultimate goal is to mass produce Flux and Flow and sell them in millions all over the world at a price that everyone, irrespective of their economic class, can afford. Cheaper versions will be lighter than the first batch of helmets Kernel will introduce to the market this year. Furthermore, Johnson hopes that many in the science and technology community will find several uses for it, such as computer scientists, neurologists, and electrical engineers. Examining the human skull from outside will also be possible at research centers. Before Kernel went afloat, about 228 investors went through the business plan, and Brian Johnson had to fund a significant portion of the investment. At some point, the company was cash-strapped, but fortunately for him and his board of directors, there were successful tests before the rise of the COVID pandemic. The tests were successful in convincing skeptics of the helmet's functionality. In his speech, unveiling the technology to press, a key part of his message centered around the great Greek phrase of ancient times, "Know yourself." There is a reason why Brian Johnson's helmet is creating a buzz within the medical science community. As of today, very little is known about the human brain, which controls the rest of the body. Scientists have relied on different kinds of instruments to measure other parts of the human anatomy, like the heart, DNA, blood, liver, and so on. However, very little is known of the brain because it is very complex. This is why the first set of helmets will be delivered to brain research institutions. Johnson says that he wants to reduce the selling price of smartphones by 2030, and one way he plans to do that is to place a helmet in every American home by making it affordable. With access to helmets, the Colonel CEO hopes that people will begin to take mental health seriously. He also hopes that his helmet will help society understand the effects of mental health complications, which has long been a bone of contention in US politics. A good way for the government to take steps towards improving the health of citizens is to buy the helmets and distribute them to citizens or subsidize the price. Brian Johnson is the brain behind the Colonel helmet. The CEO wants his helmet to be an eye-opener for everyone. At inception, he didn't know whether the helmet project would be successful or not, but he stuck to it. Unlike many modern tech billionaires in the 21st century, Brian Johnson was born poor. He was the third of five kids, born in 1977 and raised in Springville, Utah. According to him, his mother, Ellen Huff, was a devout Mormon who stayed back at home at every opportunity she could to raise her five children. The family lived a simple life and earned modest income by renting out the other wing of the family's duplex. The entrepreneur recalls weaving clothes for his mother and grinding wheat to bake bread. As for his father, he was a garbage collector who suffered from drug addiction. Both parents eventually divorced, partly due to the drug problem. He failed to meet up with his child support payments several times amid a series of legal issues. After struggling for years, about 20 years ago, Johnson Sr. was able to repair his life. And Brian Johnson admits that despite his father's drug challenges, they remained close, and his old man was a source of wisdom who gave him stability. Brian knew very little of what he wanted to do in future, but after completing his two-year church mission somewhere in Ecuador, he developed an interest in trying to help people live better lives. This vision has influenced his life in every possible way, and from all indications, may have been the reason behind his decision to fund Colonel. By investing a significant portion of his money from Braintree and Venmo into Colonel, Brian Johnson is making the world a better place. If the helmets work as well as they should, it will open up opportunities for experts to better understand how the brain works. Then moving forward, Colonel technology will be made inexpensive by reducing production costs, so every home can have the helmet. When this eventually happens, Brian Johnson can sit back with a sense of satisfaction for accomplishing what he set out to do, to make the world a better place. With that, we will bring this video to an end. If you enjoyed watching this, please consider subscribing to our channel. Leaving a like on the video and your comments also go a long way in showing your support. Till then, take care.